Hello friends, welcome to my Sakshi coaching channel. Now in this video I am going to read the chapter 8 in the NCERT biology, that is cell, the unit of life. So let's start. When you look around, you see both living and non-living things. You must have wondered and asked yourself, what is it what makes an organism living, or what is it that an inanimate thing that does not have which is a living things has? The answer to this is the presence of the basic unit of life, the cell, in the all living organisms. All organisms are composed of cells. Some are composed of a single cell and are called unicellular organisms, and while others like us composed of many cells are called multicellular organisms. What is a cell? Unicellular organisms are capable of independent existence and performing the essential functions of life. Anything less than a complete structure of a cell does not ensure independent living. Hence, cell is the fundamental structural and functional unit of all living organisms. Anton von Leeuwenhoek first saw and described a live cell. Robert Brown later discovered the nucleus. The invention of the microscope and its improvement leading to the electron microscope revealed all the structural details of the cell. Cell theory. In 1838, Malthus Schildon, a German botanist, examined a large number of the plants and observed that all plants are composed of different kinds of cells which form the tissues of the plant. At about the same time, Theodor Schwann, 1839, a British zoologist, studied different types of animal cells and reported that cells had a thin outer layer which is today known as plasma membrane. He also concluded, based on his studies on the plant tissues, that the presence of the cell wall is the unique character of the plant cells. On the basis of this, Schwann proposed the hypothesis that the body of animals and plants are composed of cells and products of cells. Schildon and Schwann together formulated the cell theory. This cell theory, however, did not explain as how new cells were formed. Rudolf Virchow in 1855 first explained that cells divided and new cells are formed from the pre-existing cells, omnis cellula e cellula. He modified the hypothesis of Schildon and Schwann to give a cell theory a final shape. Cell theory as understood today is all living organisms are composed of cells and products of cells. All cells arise from pre-existing cells. An overview of a cell. You have earlier observed cells in onion peel and or human cheek cells under the microscope. Let us recollect their structure. The onion cell, which is a typical plant cell, has a distinct cell wall as its outer boundary, and just within it is a cell membrane. The cells of the human cheek have an outer membrane as the delimiting structure of the cell. Inside each cell is a dense membrane bound structure called nucleus. This nucleus contains the chromosomes, which in turn contains the genetic material DNA. Cells that have membrane-bound nuclei are called eukaryotic, whereas cells that lack a membrane-bound nucleus are called prokaryotic. In both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, a semi-fluid matrix called cytoplasm occupies the volume of the cell. The cytoplasm is the main arena of cellular activities in both the plants and animal cells. Various chemical reactions occur in it to keep the cell in the living state. Besides the nucleus, the eukaryotic cells have other membrane-bound distinct structures called organelles, like the endoplasmic reticulum, the Golgi complex, lysosomes, mitochondria, microbodies, and vacuoles. The prokaryotic cells lack such membrane-bound organelles. Ribosomes are the non-membrane-bound organelles found in all the cells, both eukaryotic as well as prokaryotic. Within the cell, ribosomes are found not only in the cytoplasm but also within the two organelles, chloroplast in plants and mitochondria, and on rough endoplasmic reticulum. Animal cells contain another non-membrane bound organelle called centriole, which helps in cell division. Cells differ greatly in size, shape, and activities. For example, mycoplasmas, the smallest cells, are only 0.3 micrometer in length, while bacteria could be 3 to 5 micrometer. The largest isolated single cell is the egg of an ostrich. Among multicellular organisms, human red blood cells are about 7 micrometer in diameter. Nerve cells are some of the longest cells. Cells also vary greatly in their shape. They may be disc-like, polygonal, columnar, cuboid, thread-like, or even irregular. The shape of the cell may vary with the function they perform. Prokaryotic cells. The prokaryotic cells are represented by bacteria, blue-green algae, mycoplasma, and PPLO, pleuropneumonia-like organisms. They are generally smaller and multiply more rapidly than the eukaryotic cells. They may vary greatly in shape and size. The four basic shapes of the bacteria are bacillus, rod-like, coccus, spherical, vibrio, comma-shaped, and spirillum, spiral. The organization of the prokaryotic cells is fundamentally similar, even though prokaryotes exhibit a wide variety of shapes and functions. All prokaryotes have a cell wall surrounding the cell membrane. The fluid matrix filling the cell is the cytoplasm. There is no well-defined nucleus. The genetic material is basically naked and not enveloped by a nuclear membrane. In addition to the genomic DNA, the single chromosome or circular DNA, many bacteria have small circular DNA outside the genomic DNA. These smaller DNA are called plasmids. The plasmid DNA confirms certain unique phenotypic characters to such bacteria. One such character is resistance to antibiotics. In higher classes, you will learn that this plasmid DNA is used to monitor bacterial transformation with foreign DNA. Nuclear membrane is found in eukaryotes. No organelles like the ones in eukaryotes are found in the prokaryotic cells except for ribosomes. Prokaryotes have something unique in the form of inclusions. A specialized differentiated form of the cell membrane called mesosome is the characteristic of prokaryotes. They are essentially infoldings of cell membrane, cell envelope, and its modifications. Most prokaryotic cells, particularly the bacterial cells, have a chemically complex cell envelope. The cell envelope consists of a tightly bound three-layered structure, that is the outermost glycocalyx, followed by the cell wall, and then the plasma membrane. Although each layer of the envelope performs distinct function, they act together as a single protective unit. Bacteria can be classified into two groups on the basis of the differences in the cell envelopes and the manner in which they respond to the staining procedure developed by the gram. Those that take up the gram stain are called gram positive, and others that do not are called gram negative bacteria. Glycocalyx differ in composition and thickness of among different bacteria. It could be a loose sheath called the slime layer in some, while in others it may be thick and tough called capsule. The cell wall determines the shape of the cell and provides a strong structural support to prevent the bacterium from bursting or collapsing. The plasma membrane is a semi-permeable in nature and interacts with the outside world. This membrane is similar structurally to that of the eukaryotes. A special membranous structure is the mesosome, which is formed by the extensions of the plasma membrane into the cell. These extensions are in the form of vesicles, tubules, and lamellae. They help in the cell wall formation, DNA replication, and distribution of the daughter cells. They also help in respiration, secretion processes to increase the surface area of the plasma membrane and enzymatic content. In some prokaryotes, like cyanobacteria, there are other membranous extensions into the cytoplasm called chromatophores, which contain pigments. Bacterial cells may be motile or non-motile. If motile, they have a thin filamentous extensions from their cell wall called flagella. Bacteria show a range in the number and arrangement of flagella. Bacterial flagellum is composed of three parts: filament, hook, and basal body. The filament is the longest portion and extends from the cell surface to outside. Besides flagella, pili and fimbriae are the also surface structures of the bacteria, but do not play a role in motility. The pili are elongated tubular structures made up of special protein. The fimbriae are small bristle-like fibers sprouting out of the cell. In some bacteria, they are known to help to attach the bacteria to rocks in streams and also to the host tissues. Ribosomes and inclusion bodies. In prokaryotes, ribosomes are associated with the plasma membrane of the cell. They are about 15 nanometer by 20 nanometer in size and are made of two subunits, 50S and 30S units, which when present together form 70S prokaryotic ribosomes. Ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis. Several ribosomes may attach to the single mRNA and form a chain called polyribosomes or polysome. The ribosomes of a polysome translate the mRNA into proteins. Inclusion bodies, reserve material in prokaryotic cells are stored in the cytoplasm in the form of inclusion bodies. These are not bounded by any membrane system and lie free in the cytoplasm. Phosphate granules, cyanophysin granules, and glycogen granules. Gas vacuoles are found in the blue-green and purple and green photosynthetic bacteria. Eukaryotic cells. The eukaryotes include all the protists, plants, animals, and fungi. In eukaryotic cells, there is an extensive compartmentalization of cytoplasm through the presence of the membrane-bound organelles. Eukaryotic cells possess an organized nucleus with the nuclear envelope. In addition, eukaryotic cells have a variety of the complex locomotory and cytoskeletal structures. Their genetic material is organized into chromosomes. All eukaryotic cells are not identical. Plants and animal cells are different, as the former possesses cell walls, plastids, and a large central vacuole, which are absent in animal cells. On the other hand, animal cells have centrioles, which are absent in almost all the plant cells. Diagram showing A, a plant cell, and B is the animal cell. Let us now look at the individual cell organelles to understand their structure and functions. Cell membrane. The detailed structure of the membrane was studied only after the advent of the electron microscope in the 1950s. Meanwhile, chemical studies on the cell membrane, especially in human red blood cells, RBCs, enabled the scientists to deduce the possible structure of plasma membrane. These studies showed that the cell membrane is composed of lipids that are arranged in a bilayer. Also, the lipids are arranged within the membrane with the polar head towards the outer side and the hydrophobic tails towards the inner part. This ensures that the nonpolar tail of saturated hydrocarbons is protected from the aqueous environment. The lipid component of the membrane mainly consists of phosphoglycerides. Later biochemical investigations clearly revealed that the cell membranes also possesses protein and carbohydrate. The ratio of the protein and lipid varies considerably in different cell types. In human beings, the membrane of the erythrocyte has approximately 52% protein and 40% lipids. Depending on the ease of extraction, membrane proteins can be classified as integral or peripheral. Peripheral proteins lie on the surface of the membrane, while the integral proteins are partially or totally buried in the membrane. An improved model of the structure of the cell membrane was proposed by Singer and Nicholson in 1972, widely accepted as fluid mosaic model. According to this, the quasi-fluid nature of the lipid enables lateral movement of the proteins within the overall bilayer. This ability to move within the membrane is measured as its fluidity. The fluid nature of the membrane is also important from the point of view of the functions like cell growth, formation of intracellular junctions, secretion, endocytosis, cell division, etc. One of the most important functions of the plasma membrane is the transport of the molecules across it. The membrane is selectively permeable to some molecules present on either side of it. Many molecules can move briefly across the membrane without any requirement of energy, and this is called the passive transport. Neutral solutes may move across the membrane by the process of simple diffusion along the concentration gradient, that is, from higher concentration to the lower. Water may also move across the membrane from higher to the lower concentration. Movement of water by diffusion is called osmosis. As the polar molecules cannot pass through the nonpolar lipid bilayer, they require a carrier protein of the membrane to facilitate their transport across the membrane. A few ions or molecules are transported across the membrane against their concentration gradient, that is, from lower to the higher concentration. Such a transport is an energy-dependent process in which ATP is utilized and is called active process, active transport. Example, sodium-potassium pump. Cell wall. As you may recall, a non-living rigid structure called the cell wall forms an outer covering for the plasma membrane of the fungi and plants. Cell wall not only gives shape to the cells and protects the cell from the mechanical damage and infection, it also helps in the cell-to-cell interaction and provides barrier to undesirable macromolecules. Algae have a cell wall made up of cellulose, galactans, mannans, and minerals like calcium carbonate, while in other plants, it consists of cellulose, hemicellulose, pectins, and proteins. The cell wall of a young plant cell, the primary wall, is capable of growth, which gradually diminishes as the cell matures, and the secondary wall is formed on the inner, that is towards the membrane side of the cell. Middle lamella is a layer mainly of calcium pectate, which holds or glues the different neighboring cells together. The cell wall and the middle lamella may be traversed by the plasmodesmata, which connect the cytoplasm of neighboring cells. Endomembrane system. While each of the membranous organelles is distinct in terms of its structure and function, many of these are considered together as an endomembrane system because their functions are coordinated. The endomembrane system include endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes, and vacuoles. Since the functions of the mitochondria, chloroplast, and peroxisomes are not coordinated with the above components, these are not considered as the part of the endomembrane system. The endoplasmic reticulum. Electron microscopic studies of the eukaryotic cells reveal the presence of a network or a reticulum of the tiny tubular structure scattered in the cytoplasm that is called the endoplasmic reticulum. Hence, endoplasmic reticulum divides the intracellular space into two distinct compartments, that is luminal inside endoplasmic reticulum and extraluminal, that is cytoplasm compartments. The endoplasmic reticulum often shows ribosomes attached to their outer surface. The endoplasmic reticulum bearing ribosomes on their surface is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. In the absence of the ribosomes, they appear smooth and are called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is frequently observed in the cells actively involved in protein synthesis and secretion. They are extensive and continuous with the outer membrane of the nucleus. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum is the major site for a synthesis of lipid. In animal cells, lipid-like steroidal hormones are synthesized in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Golgi apparatus. Camillo Golgi in 1898 first observed densely stained reticular structures near the nucleus. These were later named Golgi bodies after him. They consist of many flat disc-shaped sacs or cisternae of 0.5 micrometer to 1 micrometer diameter. These are stacked parallel to each other. Varied number of the cisternae are present in a Golgi complex. The Golgi cisternae are concentrically arranged near the nucleus with distinct convex seas or the forming phase and concave trans or the maturing phase. The seas and the trans phases of the organelle are entirely different but interconnected. The Golgi apparatus principally performs the functions of packaging materials to be delivered either to the intracellular targets or secreted outside the cell. Materials to be packaged in the form of the vesicles from the endoplasmic reticulum fuse with the cis phase of the Golgi apparatus and move towards the maturing phase. This explains why the Golgi apparatus remains in close association with the endoplasmic reticulum. A number of proteins synthesized by the ribosomes on the endoplasmic reticulum are modified in the cisternae of the Golgi apparatus before they are released from its trans phase. Golgi apparatus is the important site for formation of glycoproteins and glycolipids. Lysosomes. These are membrane-bound vesicular structures formed by the process of packaging in the Golgi apparatus. The isolated lysosomal vesicles have been found to be very rich in almost all the types of hydrolytic enzymes, hydrolases, lipases, proteases, carbohydrates, optimally active at acidic pH. These enzymes are capable of digesting carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, and nucleic acids. Vacuoles. The vacuole is a membrane-bound space found in the cytoplasm. It contains water, sap, excretory product, and other materials not useful for the cell. The vacuole is bound by a single membrane called tonoplast. In plant cells, the vacuoles can occupy up to 90% of the volume of the cell. In plants, the tonoplast facilitates the transport of a number of ions and other materials against the concentration gradient into the vacuole. Hence, their concentration is significantly higher in the vacuole than in the cytoplasm. In amoeba, the contractile vacuole is important for the excretion. In many cells, as in protists, food vacuoles are formed by engulfing the food particles. Mitochondria. Mitochondria, unless specifically stained, are not easily visible under the microscope. The number of mitochondria per cell is variable depending on the physiological activity of the cells. In terms of the shape and size also, considerable degree of the variability is observed. Typically, it is saucer-shaped or cylindrical, having a diameter of 0.2 to 1 micrometer, average 0.5 micrometer, and the length 1 to 4.1 micrometer. Each mitochondrion is a double membrane bound structure with the outer membrane and the inner membrane dividing the lumen distinctly into two aqueous compartments, that is outer compartment and the inner compartment. The inner compartment is called the matrix. The outer membrane forms the continuous limiting boundary of the organelle. The inner membrane forms a number of the infoldings called the cristae towards the matrix. The cristae increase the surface area. The two membranes have their own specific enzymes associated with the mitochondrial function. Mitochondria are the sites of the aerobic respiration. They produce cellular energy in the form of ATP. Hence, they are called powerhouses of the cell. The matrix also possesses a single circular DNA molecule, a few RNA molecules, ribosome 70S, and the components required for the synthesis of proteins. The mitochondria divide by fission. Plastids. Plastids are found in all plant cells and in euglenoids. These are easily observed under the microscope as they are large. They bear some specific pigments, thus imparting specific colors to the plant. Based on the type of the pigment, plastids can be classified into chloroplast, chromoplast, and leucoplast. The chloroplast contain chlorophyll and carotenoid pigments, which are responsible for trapping light energy essential for the photosynthesis. In chromoplast, fat-soluble carotenoid pigments like carotene, xanthophylls, and others are present. This gives the part of the plant yellow, orange, or red color. The leucoplast are the colorless plastids of varied shapes and sizes with stored nutrients. Amyloplasts store carbohydrates, starch, example potato. Elaioplasts store oils and fats, whereas elidoplasts store proteins. Majority of the chloroplasts of the green plants are found in the mesophyll cells of the leaves. These are lens-shaped, oval, spherical, discoid, or even ribbon-like organelles having variable length 5 to 10 mm and width 2 to 4 mm. Their number varies from 1 per cell of the Chlamydomonas, a green alga, to 20 to 40 per cell in the mesophyll. Like mitochondria, the chloroplasts are also double membrane bound. Of the two, the inner chloroplast membrane is relatively less permeable. The space limited by the inner membrane of the chloroplast is called the stroma. A number of organized flattened membranous sacs called the thylakoids are present in the stroma. Thylakoids are arranged in stacks like the piles of the coins called grana, or the intergranal thylakoids. In addition, these are flat membranous tubules called the stroma lamellae connecting the thylakoids of the different grana. The membrane of the thylakoids enclose a space called a lumen. The stroma of the chloroplast contain enzymes required for the synthesis of the carbohydrates and proteins. It also contains small double-stranded circular DNA molecules and ribosomes. Chlorophyll pigments are present in the thylakoids. The ribosomes of the chloroplast are smaller, 70S, than the cytoplasmic ribosomes, 80S. Ribosomes. Ribosomes are the granular structures first observed under the electron microscope as dense particles by George Palladay in 1953. They are composed of ribonucleic acid and proteins and are not surrounded by any membrane. The eukaryotic ribosomes are 80S, while the prokaryotic ribosomes are 70S. Here S stands for the sedimentation coefficient. It is indirectly is a measure of density and size. Both 70S and 80S ribosomes are composed of two subunits. Cytoskeleton. An elaborate network of the filamentous proteinaceous structures present in the cytoplasm is collectively referred to as cytoskeleton. The cytoskeleton in a cell are involved in many functions such as mechanical support, motility, maintenance of the shape of the cell. Cilia and flagella. Cilia and flagella are the hair-like outgrowths of the cell membrane. Cilia are the small structures which work like oars, causing the movement of either the cells or surrounding fluid. Flagella are comparatively longer and responsible for the cell movement. The prokaryotic bacteria also possess flagella, but these are structurally different from that of the eukaryotic flagella. The electron microscopic study of a cilium or a flagellum shows that they are covered with the plasma membrane. Their core, called the axoneme, possesses a number of microtubules running parallel to the long axis. The axoneme usually has 9 pairs of the doublets of radially arranged peripheral microtubules and a pair of centrally located microtubules. Such an arrangement of the axonemal microtubules is referred to as 9 plus 2 array. The central tubules are connected by the bridges and is enclosed by a central sheath, which is connected to one of the tubules of each peripheral doublets by a radial spoke. Thus, there are 9 radial spokes. The peripheral doublets are also interconnected by linkers. Both the cilium and flagellum emerge from the centriole-like structures called the basal bodies. Centrosome and centrioles. Centrosome is an organelle usually containing 2 cylindrical structures called centrioles. They are surrounded by amorphous pericentriolar materials. Both the centrioles in a centrosome lie perpendicular to each other, in which each has an organization like cartwheel. They are made up of 9 evenly spaced peripheral fibrils of tubulin. Each of the peripheral fibril is a triplet. The adjacent triplets are also linked. The central part of the centriole is also proteinaceous and is called hub, which is connected to the tubules of the peripheral triplets by radial spokes made up of protein. The centrioles form the basal body of the cilia or flagella and spindle fibers that gives rise to the spindle apparatus during cell division in animal cells. Nucleus. Nucleus as a cell organelle was first described by Robert Brown as early as 1831. Later, the material of the nucleus stained by the basic dyes was given by the name chromatin by Fleming. The interphase nucleus, a nucleus of a cell when it is not dividing, has highly extended and elaborate nucleoprotein fibers called chromatin, nuclear matrix, and one or more spherical bodies called nucleoli. Electron microscopy has revealed that the nuclear envelope, which consists of 2 parallel membranes with a space between 10 to 50 nanometer called the perinuclear space, forms a barrier between the materials present inside the nucleus and that of the cytoplasm. The outer membrane usually remains continuous with the endoplasmic reticulum and also bears ribosomes on it. At a number of places, the nuclear envelope is interrupted by the minute pores, which are formed by the fusion of its 2 membranes. These nuclear pores are the passages through which movement of RNA and protein molecules takes place in the both the directions between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Normally, there is only 1 nucleus per cell. Variations in the number of the nuclei are also frequently observed. Can you recollect names of organisms that have more than 1 nucleus per cell? Some mature cells even lack nucleus, that is erythrocytes of the many mammals and pseudotube cells of the vascular plants. Would you consider these cells as living? The nuclear matrix or the nucleoplasm contains nucleolus and the chromatin. The nucleoli are spherical structures present in the nucleoplasm. The content of nucleolus is continuous with the rest of the nucleoplasm, as it is not a membrane-bound structure. It is the site for active ribosomal RNA synthesis. Larger and more numerous nuclei are present in the cells, actively carrying out protein synthesis. You may recall that the interphase nucleus has a loose and indistinct network of nucleoprotein fibers called chromatin. But during different stages of the cell division, cells show structured chromosomes in place of the nucleus. Chromatin contains DNA and some basic protein called histones, some non-histone proteins, and also RNA. A single human cell has approximately 2 meter long thread of DNA distributed among its 46 chromosomes. You will study the details of DNA packaging in the form of chromosome. Every chromosome essentially has a primary constriction or centromere on the sides of which disc-shaped structures called kinetochores are present. Based on the position of the centromere, the chromosomes can be classified into four types. The metacentric chromosome has the middle centromere forming the two equal arms of the chromosome. The submetacentric chromosome has centromere nearer to one end of the chromosome, resulting into one shorter arm and one longer arm. In case of acrocentric chromosome, the centromere is situated close to its end, forming one extremely short and one very long arm, whereas telocentric chromosome has a terminal centriole. Figure 8.12, types of chromosomes based on the position of centromere. Sometimes a few chromosomes have a non-staining secondary constriction at a constant location. This gives the appearance of a small fragment called satellite. Microbodies. Many membrane-bound minute vesicles called microbodies that contain various enzymes are present in both plant and animal cells. Summary. All organisms are made up of cells or aggregates of cells. Cells vary in their shape, size, and activities or functions. Based on the presence or absence of the membrane-bound nucleus and other organelles, cells and hence organisms can be named as eukaryotic or prokaryotic. A typical eukaryotic cell consists of a cell membrane, nucleus, and cytoplasm. Plant cells have a cell wall outside the cell membrane. The plasma membrane is selectively permeable and facilitate the transport of several molecules. The endomembrane system includes ER, Golgi complex, lysosomes, and vacuoles. All the cell organelles perform different but specific functions. Centrosome and centriole form the basal body of the cilia and flagella that facilitate the locomotion. In animal cells, centriole also form spindle apparatus during cell division. Nucleus contains nucleoli and a chromatin network. It is not only controls the activities of the organelles but also plays a major role in heredity. Endoplasmic reticulum contains tubules or cisternae. They are of two types, rough and smooth. Endoplasmic reticulum helps in the transport of substances, synthesis of proteins, lipoproteins, and glycogen. The Golgi body is a membranous organelle composed of flattened sacs. The secretions of the cells are packed in them and transported from the cell. Lysosomes are single membrane structures containing enzymes for digestion of all types of the macromolecules. Ribosomes are involved in protein synthesis. These occur freely in the cytoplasm or are associated with endoplasmic reticulum. Mitochondria help in oxidative phosphorylation and generation of adenosine triphosphate. They are bound by double membrane. The outer membrane is smooth and the inner one folds into several cristae. Plastids are the pigment containing organelles found in plant cells only. In plant cells, chloroplasts are responsible for trapping light energy essential for the photosynthesis. The grana in plastid is the site of the light reactions and the stroma of the dark reactions. The green colored plastids are chloroplasts which contain chlorophyll, whereas the other colored plastids are chromoplasts which may contain pigments like carotene and xanthophyll. The nucleus is enclosed by the nuclear envelope, a double membrane structure with the nuclear pores. The inner membrane encloses the nucleoplasm and the chromatin material. The cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Chapter completed. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos. Thank you.